Michael Jordan tells me one day he wants to be the best player to ever played here. And I said, well, you got to work harder than you did in high school. He said, I worked as hard as everybody else. I said, oh, excuse me. I thought you just told me you want to be the best player to ever play here. He said, I'm going to show you. Nobody will ever work as hard as I work.
My mentality was to go out and win at any cost. If you don't want to live that regimented mentality, then you don't need to be alongside of me, because I'm going to ridicule you until you get on the same level with me. And if you don't get on the same level, then it's going to be hell for you.
Yeah, let's not get it wrong. He was an asshole. He was a jerk. He crossed the line numerous times. But as time goes on and you think back about what he was actually trying to accomplish, you're like, yeah, he was a hell of a teammate.
He was pushing us all to be better because he wanted to win. And guess what? It worked.
I knew that Jerry Krause loved Dan Marley. And just because Krause liked him was enough for me. You think he's a great defensive player? Okay, fine. I'm going to assure you that he's not.
Jordan spins away on Marley. He'll take it all the way to the basket and drops it in.
Everybody's dreading getting back on the plane and going back to Phoenix. So I just say, look, man, I don't know about you guys. I'm only packing one suit. We going back to win one game. I'm not going there to play two games.
Michael Jordan on a point. Yes, Jordan for three. And Michael Jordan has tied the game. Jordan hits another three.
Michael had that ability where he was not going to let them lose.
My innate personality is to win at all costs. If I have to do it myself, I'm going to do it.
Every time out, he was just like gassed.
You know, a lot of times when you're sick, you're able to find something deep down inside that you didn't know was there. And I think it was just one of those games where he wanted to win so badly that, you know, he stayed with it.
After that timeout, and that whistle blew somehow, somewhere, got up and played.
Michael Jordan is back, putting the maroon on Chris Mars. Puts moves on Hornacek. We have a chance to take the lead.
At the end of that game, he started rising up and making shots and carrying that team.
And the game is tied at 85.
Barb, the Bulls have been here year after year. The confidence, the pull.
He had shown that no matter how sick he was, he's still the best player in the world.
I can't pick one moment. And when I think of Michael Jordan, yes, I think of the shot. But I think of 3 years of watching that youngster get better and better and better. Michael Jordan's the only player that could ever turn it on and off. And he never freaking turned it off.
Jordan, look at that!
So when you weren't getting paid?
7:30?
I've been.
That fueled me more so than anything. And it drove me to make this thing work. I gotta play catch up, but I'm gonna do it.
His work ethic was the best I've ever been around. He would hit early in the day. He'd hit off the breaking ball machine. He would come in after regular batting practice, hit some more before the game, and then would hit again after the game.
After the season, usually there's a time period where Michael takes some time off. The night they lost Orlando, I said, Michael, you know, I'm about to get out of here. Let me know when you want me to see you, because I'll see you tomorrow.
The athletic director of Hanover County Schools called us and said, I've got a guy down here I think may have a chance. And that was Mike Jordan. And so we invited him to our basketball camp. When he got here, we knew of him. We'd heard he was pretty good. 5 days later, when we left here, we thought he was the best player in America.
Big downfall of a lot of players who are otherwise gifted is thinking about failure. Michael didn't allow what he couldn't control to get inside his head. He would say, why would I think about missing a shot I haven't taken yet?
Michael had an obligation to himself, the fans, his teammates, the organization, his family, everybody. He said, if you're gonna sit down and take 3 hours out of your day to watch me on TV, I have an obligation to give you my best. To give you my best all the time.
I never gave up. Every time we were close, I knew we were gonna do it.
1998 NBA Finals, MVP, Michael Jordan.